I have had the best time. I don't know anybody that's had a better time working than I have had.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
I cannot overstate how much I am in awe of what fine actors accomplish.
Watergate!
God damn it!
You shouldn't swear like that!
You shouldn't swear like that.
I didn't
you
swear.
I did not.
Ever since this Watergate thing, it's GD this and GD that.
That ain't swearing either, GD. The first word there is God, ain't it? How can that be a swear word, the most popular word in the Bible? The second word, that's damn much a perfectly good word. You read where some guy is damned for cheating or stealing or committing incest in the family. And who damned him? Who else? God! God damned him! Ain't it beautiful words right out of the holy book? Don't show your rich.
I don't understand you sometimes. All I'm trying to do is make a better life for all of us.
James, is it worth it leaving your family for a whole year? Do we live that bad?
Well, let's face it, Florida, we don't live that good. I mean, we are poor. And if you was to make a list of all the things that people want to be, poor would be right down at the bottom of the list, just above sick and dead.
Everybody on your show has been so wonderful.
Oh, they're nice people.
In making this trip, because I was a little nervous, you know.
Well, no. You are just going to find that people in show business are as nice and warm and sweet in their own way as the folks back home.
And also, you have that wonderful producer, Mr. Tata Schwartz. And, you know, I was talking to the makeup man, and he says to me, I was, you know, surprised. He said, they's all Jewish. I just couldn't believe that his was the people that what killed our Lord, you know.
Do you know what I found?
No, ma'am.
I found this lint ball on one of the guest towels. I'm sorry to have to have done that, Charlotte, but we have discussed this problem dozens of times, and it just doesn't seem to sink in.
It will now, ma'am.
Well, we've been doing about 2 years of research involving the carcinogenic properties of various synthetic fabrics.
Well, we have a lot of laymen here tonight, and
for sure.
And what is that exactly in layman's terms?
Well, very simply stated, it means that leisure suits cause cancer.
So how did you get all this phenomenal information?
We did exhaustive research involving thousands of laboratory rats. We dress them in these tiny leisure suits.
If we have a problem, why can't we just talk it through? Like Tom and Helen, they don't fight.
They don't fight because they're scared to fight.
What's that supposed to mean?
You know damn well what it means. If you two ever really started going at one another, inside of 5 minutes, he'd be calling you...
Don't say it.
Nigga.
He said it.
You listen to me. We've had lots of fights, and it's never happened.
Oh, and don't tell me it never crossed your mind.
No more than it ever crossed my mind to say the word hunky to Tom.
Ha! Well, how come you said it just then?
Come on, let's go.
You know, I've been thinking. There is no earthly reason for you to go through with this at your age. You know it, I know it, Walter knows it.
I don't want you to talk about it. Just don't talk about it.
I didn't say anything, but now that you mentioned it, it's legal in New York now, isn't it?
Oh, of course it is, Walter. Mother, I don't understand your hesitancy. When they made it a law, you were for it.
Of course, I wasn't pregnant then.
I got a Yankee Doodle sweetheart.
Who is she? The Statue of Miss Liberty.
She's my
Oh, don't tell me. Are we?
Yes, Mary, we are.
I can't believe it. That I, Mary Hartman, am finally a member of a Nielsen family.
Much more.
God'll get you for that.
I never knew, and I think to myself,
will you stifle, you silly demon?
What a wonderful world.
One, two, three.
Robert Louis Stevenson said that traveling hopefully is better than to arrive. There's only one arrival in life, and that's the end of life. You don't arrive until the conclusion. I would hope to travel hopefully for a long time towards that conclusion.
Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.